24 hours after protesters marched onto a Milwaukee freeway, that same group is back and they've spent tonight in the neighborhoods. Michelle Fiore has been following the group and joins us live from the north side. Hey, Michelle.
And Jessup, demonstrators tonight brought these handouts, boxes and boxes of them. These handouts asking people to contact their lawmaker, saying if you weren't able to march with them, you can do something else, because if you want justice for all, we need to change the law.
Justice for Dante, right?
Voices fill Milwaukee streets 2 days after a police officer in Minnesota mistakenly used her gun, not taser, killing Dante Wright.
Every night is different. It's all about coming back out here and hitting the pavement for the people who can't come out here. Dante Wright can't march no more. George Floyd, Alvin Cole.
This is the second night where the People's Revolution invited others to join them in Milwaukee, starting at Indigenous People's Park, then winding through Northside neighborhoods, gaining support along the way.
And I see these people falling by. It inspires me. You know, I'm a Black American, and I see with the murders that's happening with unarmed Black people, I see myself in these young people.
On Monday night, the group started with a small car parade, ultimately landing on I-43, where protesters jumped out of their cars. They held up traffic as they walked on the freeway for over a mile. Organizers agree it's a dangerous stance, but they go through dangers every single day.
We're concerned for our safety every day. The thing is, like, we live in a world where we can be violently murdered by absolutely anybody. And depending on who does it, nobody's held accountable for it.
So we're back at Indigenous People's Park. This street behind me was filled with cars. Just about 15 minutes ago, they all dispersed, seemingly protesters going home for the night. Reporting live on the north side, I'm Michelle Fiore. Back to you in the studio.